Okay, first I want to give you a general overview of what the terms web hosting and WordPress mean. You probably hear them all the time, and yet there are many people out there who only have kind of a hazy understanding of their definitions. First, let's start with web hosting. So what is web hosting? In a nutshell, web hosting is the rented space where you put your website. It's essentially where your website lives. It's the service that provides storage space and allows you to access your website. If you have a website, it has to be hosted somewhere. It has to live somewhere. There's no getting around that. Some people choose to sign up and set up their web hosting with companies like HostGator for a small monthly fee, while others choose to sign up with a website service that takes care of web hosting for them. There are pros and cons to each approach, and it really depends on your business's needs. For those who want more flexibility, control, functionality, and often more scalability with their business website, they set up their web hosting with a company like HostGator, and then they go out and select which content management system or blog platform they want to install. Others might choose to go with a service like Squarespace or Weebly, which handles the web hosting for them, and then they don't have to sign up with a company like HostGator, but it only gives you the option to use their content management system, Squarespace, Weebly, whatever. And this means you only get the functionality that they give you. Some people think this is fine, and that's cool. Some people want more. It really depends on your personal preferences and what your individual business's needs are. One of the most popular decisions for many small businesses is to set up their web hosting with a company like HostGator, which takes like 15 minutes. And then they go on to install WordPress, which that takes like another 5 minutes because HostGator makes it super easy. Okay, we just talked about web hosting. Let's move on to WordPress. So what is WordPress? And why is it so popular? WordPress.org is one of the most popular free blogging platforms today. It's used for both blogs and websites. Wikipedia explains it well. It says WordPress is a free and open source blogging tool and a content management system which runs on a web hosting service. For this course, we will be focusing on WordPress.org, which offers the most functionality and freedom. Now, just a quick note, WordPress.com is similar to WordPress.org. It handles the hosting for you, but it has many more limitations. Again, we'll be focusing on WordPress.org, which is much more robust and flexible. And with WordPress, you can install templates, you can install themes, and these things really cut down on the time you spend designing your website. It's awesome. There are both free and paid themes out there, and numerous sites offer them. In addition, you can easily install plugins on your WordPress website. Plugins essentially add functionality above and beyond what you get out of the box with a basic WordPress installation. There are both free and paid plugins out there. Some examples of the added functionality you get with plugins include enhanced navigation bars, better SEO, which stands for search engine optimization, portals where people can sign up and log in to see private information on your site, opt-in boxes where people can opt into offers with their email address. You can find plugins that help you enhance image galleries, and there's so much more. The sky is really the limit, and there are new plugins being created every single day. Okay, so we just talked about WordPress. Now, how does all this relate to web hosting? Well, you have to install WordPress somewhere. Once you have your web hosting set up, you then go ahead and install WordPress on that web server. A web server is a computer that you can access over the internet. It allows you to upload and store files, which is essentially what you're doing when you add images and pages to your website. Okay, now that you have a very basic understanding of web hosting and WordPress, I'll show you how to sign up for a basic hosting plan, and after that, we'll install WordPress. All right, let's do it.